गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन चिल्ड्रन वी वर डूइंग द एक्सरसाइजेस ऑफ चैप्टर एसिड बेसिस एंड सॉल्ट्स वी हैव ऑलरेडी कम्प्लीटेड पार्ट ए बी सी एंड डी नाउ वी विल डू द ई पार्ट दैट इज द लॉन्ग आंसर टाइप क्वेश्चन सो द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज ऑल alkalis are bases but all bases are not alkalis justify this statement all alkalis are bases but all bases are not alkalis so children it is given in page number 48 in page number 48 you see here it is given that Bases are substances which react with acid to form water and salt. Then some bases are soluble in water. Such bases are called alkalis. For example, you can take sodium hydroxide and aluminium hydroxide. These both are bases. Okay? Sodium hydroxide and aluminium hydroxide are both bases. But sodium hydroxide is soluble in water. That's why sodium hydroxide is termed as an alkalis. Hence we can say that all alkalis are bases, but all bases are not alkalis. That is question number E1. Now come to the E2. Here you have to suggest an activity that can help one to decide whether a given solution is acidic or basic in nature. So, solution is given and you have to detect it, you have to decide it whether the given solution is acidic or basic in nature. So, in this, children, you can do that litmus paper activity, isn't it? You have to take the solution in a petri dish and then what you have to do? You have to dip litmus paper into it. First of all, you will dip a red litmus paper into it. If the color changes into blue, that is the litmus paper changes from red to blue, then the given solution is basic in nature and when the litmus paper changes from blue to red, then you can say that the given solution is acidic in nature. Clear to everyone now? Now we will proceed to the question number 3. That is, write chemical equations for the following reaction. Here you have to write the chemical equation. Okay, no need to write in form of language. Only you have to just write in the chemical equation form. So first one is calcium hydroxide reacts with nitric acid. So what happens when or how the reaction takes place when calcium hydroxide that is CaOH twice reacts with what? Calcium hydroxide reacts with nitric acid, that is HNO3. So the product formed will be CaNO3 twice plus 2H2O plus 2H2O and once again, you have to see that whether the equation is balanced or not. See here children, CaNO3 twice, but NO3 is only one here, so you have to put a 2 over here, then CaNO3, then H2O4, oxygen 2. The reaction is completely balanced now, okay? So, this is the E3-1. Then the second equation is to what happens when, or write the chemical equation when acetic acid reacts with calcium hydroxide. Now, acetic acid, what is the formula of acetic acid? CH3COOH. It is CH3COOH. So acetic acid reacts with calcium hydroxide. Again, calcium hydroxide is here. Yes. So you know what is the formula of calcium hydroxide? CaOH twice. Then what you have to do? You have to write the product. What happens? What is formed here? CH3 from here. Okay. Then COO from here. That is this one. CH3COO. Okay. And Ca. As we know that the valency of calcium is 2. So CH3 hold to Ca. It is calcium acetate plus 2H2O. So here you can write down, it is calcium acetate. Here also you can write down this one in the first one, children. That is, it is calcium nitrate. Okay. Here you can write calcium nitrate. Then you see here what is formed here, calcium acetate and water. So here you see CH3COO twice. So here also you have to write 2 to balance it. Then now it is balanced. 2 hydrogen here, 2, 2 plus 2, 4 hydrogen, 2 to the 4 hydrogen. Then 2 oxygen, 2 oxygen. So it is balanced now. Now let us see what is given in the third one. Third one is hydrochloric acid reacts with sodium hydroxide. Hydrochloric acid HCl reacts with sodium hydroxide, that is NaOH. What will be the product formed here? NaCl, that is sodium chloride plus water. See here, it is already balanced. 2 hydrogen is here and 1 plus 1, 2 hydrogen is here. Then Na, 1 Na sodium atom is here and 1 chlorine, NaCl, 1 both. Okay, so it is balanced. And here you can write the name also of, that is sodium chloride. It is sodium chloride. Now fourth one, what is the question? Ammonium hydroxide reacts with sulfuric acid. Ammonium hydroxide reacts with sulfuric acid. So what is the formula of ammonium hydroxide? It is NH4OH. Ammonium hydroxide reacts with sulfuric acid. What is the formula of sulfuric acid? It is H2SO4. Clear? Ammonium hydroxide plus sulfuric acid. What will be the product formed here? It will be ammonium sulfate. Ammonium from this side and sulfate from this side. So it will be NH4 twice SO4, ammonium sulfate plus water, 2H2O. Ammonium sulfate, here you see 2 molecules of ammonium ion is here. So you have to make it here also too, in order to make it balance. Okay. Then you see here 2 hydrogen plus 2 hydrogen, 4 hydrogen atom is here. Here also 2 into 2, 4. Then oxygen, you see 2, 2 oxygen is here, here also 2 oxygen, 1 sulfate, 1 sulfate, and 2 ammonium, 2 ammonium. So the equation is balanced now. Then what is the next question? You say, state the differences between neutral, acidic and basic salt and give one example of each. You have to write down the difference between neutral, acidic and basic salt. So what are the neutral salt? Salt which are formed by the strong acid and strong base. Salt which is formed by strong acid and strong base. Is known as the neutral salt. Salt which is formed by strong acid plus strong base is known as neutral salt. And strong acid you can take what? Hydrochloric acid, it is strong acid. Strong base you can take NaOH, sodium hydroxide, it is strong base. Then the salt formed will be NaCl plus H2O. It is the neutral one, isn't it? Now, the second one, this is the neutral salt. Now, then acidic salt. Acidic salt, children, you know very well that salt which is formed by strong acid and weak base, that is strong acid plus weak base will be acidic salt, that is acidic salt. Here also you can take an example that salt which is formed by strong acid and weak base is known as acidic salt. So you can take strong acid, you can take HCl, that is hydrochloric acid is a strong acid. Then weak base, here you have to take weak base, you can take aluminium hydroxide AlOH thrice. It is the formula of aluminium hydroxide. Then the salt formed will be AlCl3, that is aluminium chloride, and then you have to make it balance plus 3H2O. This is the acidic salt. Why it is an acidic salt? Because it is formed by strong acid, that is hydrochloric acid, and weak base, that is aluminium hydroxide. And the salt obtained is aluminium chloride, which is acidic salt. Now, the third one is basic salt. So, what are the basic salt? Basic salts are the salts which is formed by strong base. Salt formed by strong base plus weak acid is known as the basic salt. So here also you can take an example of strong base. We can take the example of sodium hydroxide, it is a strong base. And weak acid, here you can take acetic acid, it is a weak acid, acetic acid. Then what will be the product formed? CH3, COO from here and Na from here, and water, that is H2O. And this is the what type of salt? It is basic salt, and its name is sodium acetate. Its name is sodium acetate, and it is the basic salt. Why? Because it is formed by strong base, that is sodium hydroxide, and weak acid, that is acetic acid. So the salt formed is, so in the differences you can write that the basic salts are the salts which is formed by strong base and weak acid. For example, sodium acetate. Acidic salts are the salt which is formed by strong acid and weak base. For example, aluminium chloride. The neutral salts are the salts which is formed by this combination of strong acid and strong base. For example, sodium chloride. Okay. Now, what is the next question? Question number 5th. Describe an activity to show that the solution of salt in water can conduct electricity. Children, we had already discussed the activity. And here you have to show that in the activity you have to show that solution of salt in water can conduct electricity. We had already discussed the activity. See here, it is given in page number, yes, in page number 51. You see activity 4. How? In page number 51, the activity is given here. With the help of this activity, you can prove that the solution of salt is capable to conduct electricity. So here you see, you have to take a beaker, then the salt solution and 2 graphite rod. You have to dip here into this solution, salt solution, and then you have to prepare an electrical circuit. And in this circuit, a bulb is connected, and when current is passed through this circuit, then what happens? The bulb glows, indicating that the salt solution helps to conduct electricity. So children, the chapter is completed. That is the last question, I think. Now, yes, describe an activity. It is the last question. So the chapter is completed. All part A, B, C, D and E, all are completed. Now children, you note down your home assignment. Your home assignment is do part D and E of chapter Acids, Bases and Salts.